طريقتنا الصحبة والخير في الجمعية. Our way is companionship and goodness is with the group of believers, group of people who come to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The way is to be, tariqah is to make us good servants. It's not to accumulate ilm. It's not to become something. It's to become a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala akram ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He honored the nation of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with so many gifts and favors. كنتم خيرا واستعذ بالله كنتم خيرا أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. And throughout the ages, ulama understood that the secret behind تفضيل الله لأمة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, that the secrets behind Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granting the ummah the honor of being khayrul umam is that it is connected to Sayyid al-Mursaleen, Habibullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Imam al-Muttaqeen. That is the reality of this tafdeel, is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala connected us with His most beloved, most honored, most praiseworthy servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Sayyidina Muhammad. Because of that connection, we became the best ummah. Our duty is to be grateful that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us that ni'mah. We are now coming, and this ummah has so many opportunities to exceed previous nations. They had to worship for years. The followers of Sayyidina Musa had to be in Khalwa for 60, 70, 80 years to be considered Abid. Yani they lived longer also. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He gave us these easy passes, you know. One day on Arafah, أحتسب على الله يكفر السنة الماضية والسنة اللي بعدها, كما قال النبي. That Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that on Arafah, forgiveness of previous year and coming year, and for Ashura the previous year, one day of Siyam, one day of Ta'abbud, and the sins of previous year are erased. This is one day coming Ashura now, Tuesday. And sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he went to Medina, we read the hadith for barakah. فقد ورد في الصحيح عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال صيام يوم عرفة يوم عرفة أحتسب على الله أن يكفر السنة التي قبله والسنة التي بعده وصيام يوم عاشوراء أحتسب على الله أن يكفر السنة التي قبله. And the hadith where Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم went to Medina, قد جاء في الصحيح حين صام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يوم عاشوراء وأمر بصيامه قالوا يا رسول الله إنه يوم تعظمه اليهود والنصارى. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فإذا كان العام المقبل إن شاء الله صمنا اليوم التاسع. قال فلم يأتي العام المقبل حتى توفي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he ordered companions to fast the day of Ashura, They said, O Prophet ﷺ, this is a day that is glorified by the Bani Israel, by the Jews. He asked him, he said, then next year I will fast the day, the ninth also, not just the tenth day. مُخَالَفَةً لِلْيَهُودِ, that he will fast the ninth day. And there's narrations where also the 11th day, the 10th and 11th day of the month. And so Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wa sallam clarified for us the importance of this day. It is the day where Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam was delivered from the hands of Fir'aun. And Bani Israel were delivered, the sea opened for them, and they were delivered. Why is it important to observe these days? It's important to know when they're happening, and it's important to take advantage of these opportunities. Who doesn't want his sins to be forgiven for one whole year? Who doesn't have sins, first of all? Only the prophets are infallible. So hadith wala haraj, as they say. Sins by the buckets these days. Everywhere you look, everything you touch, the money in dunya now is all filthy. They say every dollar has been borrowed 99 times. Monetary system is messed up. We're connected to devices. Even you're not intending, things pop up in front of you. You have no control over that. Your ears are hearing things all the time that are nonsense, malayani, or even haram. So whether sins we know or sins we don't know, we are, from the moment we open our eyes until nighttime, exposed to things that are not acceptable. Fighting, arguing, jealousy, that's besides those inner sins. A'mal qulub, besides having envy, having greed, having jealousy, having stinginess, having all this stuff. And we're talking just about the open ones. So sins, you can't count the sins. So we need kafara, we need something to erase. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us these opportunities, Ashura. It is a day our mashayikh also, in the book of Wasiyah of Mawlana of Shaykh Adnan, that on this day, because it is a special day, there's hadith Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that for whoever spends money, and not spends money, wasa'a ala ayali, whoever increases the rizq on his family, ala ahli, waqala an-nabi, whoever increases in spending on his own family on the day of Ashura, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase his rizq for the whole year. From fadail al-amal, this is something the ummah did throughout the ages. Now they'll come to you and say, oh, it's hadith da'if. Fadail al-amal, in increasing doing goodness, you can take with a hadith da'if. You can do that. It's no problem. Hadith da'if is not mawdu'. Means there's some issue with its isnad, with its rijal, something that doesn't make it unacceptable. Hadith da'if. So on this day, Tuesday is coming. If you have some major shopping to buy or things to buy for the, do it on Tuesday. Do it on that day. Spend more money on your family on that day than you spend on normal days. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase our sustenance for the entire year. Even istanbatu, because cutting the nails, kuhul on that day, showering on that day, on Ashura is also recommended in by Mawlana Sheikh Nazim in his wasiyah. So if you can do it, shower. People shower every day. Shower on Ashura. If you want to cut your nails, try to make it on that day also. Like that. Yani try to do as many good deeds as possible on the day of Ashura. Fast, give charity if you can. Maximize your return on this day. Inshallah, may Allah accept. And the fact that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has named Shahr Muharram Shahrullah wa tasmiyatuhu bi Shahrillah dalil ala sharafihi wa rafati. Yani it is one from the Ashur al-Hurum. It's an important month. It's also a month in which Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the best fast after Ramadan is the fast of Muharram. So I'm trying to encourage myself first, fast. You can increase fast as much as you can in this month, if you can, besides Ashura. Fast that 9th day, 10th day, 11th day, you have also the Ayyam al-Bid, white days coming. As much as a person, his health allows him, and circumstances, try to fast as much as you can. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad hatta yarda. So it's a day of victory. It is mentioned in the Athar that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, that the ship of Nuh landed on that day, on Ashura, that Sayyidina Isa was raised and protected from his assailants on Ashura, that even in the book of Sheikh Adnan saying that the birth of Sayyidina Isa was on Ashura. Wallahu a'lam. It is a holy day. But it's also because of what happened to Sayyidina al-Husayn. I don't know what happened with the chairs, huh? They're gone. We have one, I think. We took him for an event and we have yet to return. Alaykum salam. I think we should start the zikr at 7:30. Everybody will get here on 8, at 8. Sheikh? Everybody is very timely. I was trained differently. We used to wait for, not claiming to be sheikhs or anything, but we used to go wait for the sheikh, and he arrives 20 minutes late, half an hour late, 1 hour late, sometimes 1.5 hours late. You are waiting. That's how it used to be. Sheikh, alhamdulillah. It's okay. Even when I got so used to being timely serving, that even sometimes I want to be late. Like I want to come late. I don't want to be the first one there, you know. But even sometimes when I try, I'm 15, 20 minutes late, I'm still the first one there. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad hatta yarda. So we have to be aware of the fitan of the times as well. And this month, a very difficult happening happened to the sibt of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sayyidina al-Husayn, Sayyidina Abu Abdullah al-Husayn, and 72 with him, members of his household, members of the household of Sayyidina al-Hasan, that were martyred on this day. So this year you will see online, you will see on social media, this is like the Mawlid season. You know, as soon as the Mawlid starts, you start to get all these videos. Mawlid is bid'ah, Mawlid is haram, Mawlid is this. As soon as Ashura turn around, comes around, you start to hear. How could you celebrate the day of Ashura, the day of as the deliverance, when the family of Prophet ﷺ, this happened to them, that we don't, people who do, they don't care about the family of Prophet ﷺ. So where is the haqq in this? The reality of the matter is, Sayyidina al-Husayn's martyrdom on Ashura is a bushra. Allah chose for him to be martyred with his entire family, almost, on such a holy day. This could have happened any other day. But Allah chose a day that where He gave victory to His believing servants for the Sayyidina al-Husayn to be martyred on that day, and his entire family to be martyred on that day. So from one side, it looks like that this happened and this horrible act by the Ummah against the grandson. He was the last grandson of a prophet, not of one prophet. There was no other grandson of a prophet after Sayyidina al-Husayn. Yeah? Alayhi salam. Because he was the last grandson of the last prophet. There was nobody, yani, just that the Ummah murdered, yani, killed the last grandson of the Prophet upon whose hands Allah gave so much khair to this Ummah. Just that fact makes you sad. How could the Ummah al-Islam, how could we do this? But this is one end. This is one dimension to what happened. On the other dimension, you have Prophet ﷺ said, Al-Hasan al-Husayn, Sayyida Shababi Ahli al-Jannah. They are the masters of the martyr of the youth of heavens. Yani in heaven, your master is Sayyidina al-Husayn. If Allah grants us to go to heaven, our ashyad. Now they say, don't say Sayyid for Sayyidina Muhammad. And if you say Sayyidina al-Husayn, they say, why are you saying Sayyidina al-Husayn? Or Sayyidina al-Hasan, oh, why are you saying Sayyidina? No, it's okay. You don't want him to be your Sayyid. Maybe you're not meant to go to heaven. Because in heaven, he's your Sayyid. Sayyida. If you don't want to be Sayyidina al-Husayn to be your Sayyid, well, you don't want to be in your group. نحن, we say, Alhamdulillah, he is our master. Dunya and Akhirah. Sayyidina al-Husayn and Sayyidina al-Hasan. We give them, we not give them, we acknowledge their siyada from now, here. They are our masters. And we hope to be also, to call them our masters in heavens, inshallah. That's what we hope. They are the Sayyida. طيب, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, الأنبياء أشد ابتلاء, الأنبياء have the highest affliction in dunya. And Sayyidina Muhammad as their master is the most afflicted in dunya. ثم الأمثل فالأمثل. When you understand that they are the masters of paradise, that means their afflictions are heavy in dunya. So Sayyidina al-Hasan also was martyred and poisoned. But this is not something as a negative thing in their right. No. This is ishara for those who can see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took 72 of the household of Prophet ﷺ in one day and made them martyrs and made them asyad of heavens. Is that victory or not? Not only that, their actions and their sacrifices we're also safeguarding the ummah from falsehood, from people who sell their religion for dunya. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tried them with a test to accept falsehood, to sign off for those who want to sell religion bi'aradin min ad-dunya, for cheap dunya, he said no. Not because he wanted Sayyidina al-Husayn to be king. No, because this is not acceptable. Because the agreement before him, his brother, Sayyidina al-Hasan alayhi salam, made the agreement that after the rule of Muawiyah bin Abi Sufyan, that it will be shura, Amrul Muslimin will be shura between them. It will go back to, the Muslims will decide who their leaders are. At the end of his rule, he made his son, it became kingdom. So Sayyidina al-Husayn could not accept, because Prophet ﷺ said, أنا من حسين وحسين مني, Hadith al-Nabi. That I am from Hussein and Hussein is from me. And they say that one meaning is that his character, the character of Sayyidina al-Hussein, that he is unwavering on haqq. He cannot accept. He cannot move. As Prophet ﷺ, when they said, if they put the sun in my right and the moon in my left to leave this duty or that Allah has given me, I will not leave it until either it's accomplished or ahlak. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they say that Sayyidina al-Husayn has inherited that character of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he was aware that they were after him. He knew that they wanted him. And he knew that they wanted him out of the way. And he was warned by Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas. He saw a vision that Prophet ﷺ presented him with a flask full of blood. And he said, this is the blood of Hussein and his family. And he told this to Sayyidina al-Hussein. We're not bringing this to... But we're bringing this to remind ourselves of the sacrifices of Ahlul Bayt. Yes, but the sacrifices go back to even Sayyidina al-Hasan. Those who use Sayyidina al-Husayn as a flag to differentiate between the Ummah, they must understand why we don't celebrate Sayyidina al-Hasan. Sayyidina al-Hasan's sacrifices are less. He was martyred, he was poisoned for standing on haqq. Why don't they commemorate the sacrifices of Sayyidina Ali bin Abi Talib? Karramallahu wajhahu wa radiyallahu anhu. He was martyred standing to pray by those who wanted to divide the ummah, Muslims. Why they don't celebrate and honor the sacrifice of Sayyidina Hamza? Huh? Why they don't honor the sacrifice of Sayyidina Ja'far al-Tayyar? Why we don't honor their days? Why we don't honor Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's? Why they make such a big fuss about Sayyidina Muhammad? He said that the Ummah has not been afflicted with a bigger affliction than my leaving this dunya. The biggest affliction. He even, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, if you have an affliction, remember my loss. If you have a big affliction that is afflicting you, remember that you lost the physicality, physical presence, Remember that, and it will make your other afflictions easy. So why they don't do this hustle and bustle every year for Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Means there's something behind it. It's not an innocent thing. There's something to it. No, Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we are sad that we are from Ummatul Islam and that this blemish on the history of Muslims, that they killed the grandson of their prophet. This makes us sad. This makes us... It's a painful thing to think about. But we also understand that this is a great honor for Sayyidina Hussein. The sacrifice of Sayyidina al-Hassan, the sacrifice of Sayyidina Ali bin Abi Talib, radiallahu anhum, ajma'in. Sayyidina Hamza, Sayyidina Ja'far al-Tayyar, and after them, many from Ahlul Bayt, until today. So we're not going to use this occasion to distinguish ourselves. And the claim, like right now, it's easy sitting in your air-conditioned home or masjid to say, oh, we love Sayyidina al-Hussein. Oh, had we been at the time of Sayyidina al-Hussein, we would have been with Sayyidina al-Hussein. How do you know? How do you know you wouldn't have made the choice these miserable people made? Forget that. We said earlier, are we haqqani in everything? You know, right now, the choices that are facing us, are we always choosing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah's pleasure in our lives? Whenever we're faced with choices, are we always putting ahead of everything Allah's rida with us? And small things, not big things. So how do you know if you were back then, you would have made these choices? Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not afflict us like that. Inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on Tuesday we will do Ashura commemoration. We will read the names of Sayyidina al-Husayn and the Shuhada of Karbala and ask their intercession. Ask that they intercede for us, because we believe their maqam is high. But this charade that is done every year of dividing the ummah based on how they react to an occasion that happened 1400 years ago, a little bit less than 1400 years. If you don't behave in a certain way, then you don't love Ahlul Bayt. No. Alhamdulillah, inshallah, we love Ahlul Bayt. Inshallah, we honor their sacrifices. Inshallah, we hope to be with them in Akhirah. But we don't have to behave in a specific way. We do it according to the manners of Islam. We make dhikr, we make dua, we make salah ala nabi, we honor and praise Sayyidina Muhammad. Huh? This is how we honor. We don't honor by things that are not from this religion. May Allah forgive us. May Allah guide all the ummah back to the way of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ومن الله التوفيق بحرمة الحبيب بحرمة الفاتحة.